Python if is a single alternative, and if-else is a dual alternative decision structure. But what if we need a multiple alternative decision structure? What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com. Welcome to another Python programming tutorial. In this video, we will learn the concepts of else-if Python statement. In simple words, today we are going to learn about Python if-else ladder. But before we start, if you are new here, then please consider subscribing to the channel as I upload easy to learn Python programming tutorials every week. Also, please make sure to hit the thumbs up button if you like the video. Now, let's start. Suppose your university or school asked you to develop an application. One of the modules of that application requires you to tell the students their division of passing based on their marks. You are also provided with some initial criteria using which you must design this module. That criteria is: student with marks over 50 and less than 60 has passed with the second division. Student with marks over 60 and less than 75 has passed with the first division. Whereas the student with marks over 75 and less than 90 has passed with the first division with distinction. And if a student has got marks over 90, then he or she has passed with an outstanding performance. We clearly have four conditions. These four conditions will be used for deciding. Let's see how to implement a module based on these criteria using Python if statement. Using else-if Python statement. Let's do it. There are two ways of doing this. The first one is to write a complex nested Python if-else structure. Let me show you how that will look. Here in this program, we are writing a Python if clause and an else clause. Furthermore, inside that else clause, we are again writing another if and else clause. And we are repeating this process. Though this program is producing the result, yet not in an efficient way. Don't you think that this program is already very confusing? What if we need to add four more conditions? Then this will become an out of control mess, right? Don't worry, the Python programming is all about making programmers' life a lot easier. That's why we are provided with a simple way to deal with such complex situations, and it is called else-if Python statement. Else-if is an acronym of else-if. Else-if Python statement is multiple alternative conditional control decision structure. This is also a simplified version of nested if-else statement of Python programming. You will see that in a minute. But first, let's look at the syntax of else-if Python statement. Except for the else-if part, the syntax is pretty much the same as the Python if statement which we saw in the last video. Let me quickly brief you. Firstly, you need to make sure that all the keywords such as if, else, and else-if must always be in small letters. Secondly, the indentation of all these keywords must always be consistent. In simple words, they all need to be aligned at the same level. Next, always make sure to end all the clauses such as if clause, else-if Python clause, or else clause with a colon. Putting a colon right after the condition in an if clause, elif clause, or else clause is mandatory. Now, let's talk about the body of these clauses. Their bodies can contain any type of valid Python statement. It could be a simple Python print statement or a complex calculation. But all these statements must always be right indented. They also need to be aligned consistently. Simply put, all the statements must be right aligned and must be at same level. Now the only thing in this syntax which is left is the condition. If you have noticed, except from the else clause, all the others, whether it's if clause or the elif clause, have a condition. This condition is the expression which gets checked either for true or false. Now that we have learned the syntax of Python elif clause, let's move ahead and modify the previous code. Let's do one thing. Let's clear this worksheet and rewrite this code, but this time using the elif Python clause. Done. First, we need to let the student enter his or her total marks. Thus, here we are taking a float input from the user. Next, we will write the elif Python statement. Fine, call it whatever you want, Python if-else statement or else if statement. Anyway. Here is our Python if statement. This is going to address our first condition, where a student will get notified that he or she has got second division if his or her marks are between 50 to 60%. Mind here we have used AND Boolean operator, which means both the conditions marks underscore OBT greater than equal to 50 and marks underscore OBT less than 60 need to be true. If both these conditions get evaluated as true, then only the interpreter will execute the underlying Python print function. Now let's move on and write the next part of the program. Here is our first elif clause. Using this clause, we are checking the second condition. This clause will execute only if the marks obtained by the students are greater than equal to 60% and less than 75%. If this condition is satisfied, then the interpreter will run the underlying Python print function call. Now let's write the code for remaining conditions. But before that, can you spot what is wrong with this elif clause? Right. In the elif clause, we need to put the colon after the condition, not after the keyword. Thus, the first colon will cause the error and therefore I will delete it from here. Now, this is a perfect elif Python statement. Here we are. In the second elif clause, we are letting the students know that they have got first division with distinctions only if they have obtained marks between 75 to 90%. Furthermore, in the last elif clause, we are congratulating the students who have secured marks over 90% on their outstanding performance. This program isn't complete yet. Did you notice that in this Python program we have not included any use case for those students who have failed the class? Now you ask, do we need to write another elif Python clause for that? No, we don't need to do that. We can easily cover that case simply by adding an else clause to this program. Let's do that. Now we have covered all the use cases. This is the complete Python program for the conditions given to us. Let's add one more Python print function, which will be outside the scope of this Python if-else block. As this print function is outside the scope of our if-else block, Thus, it will execute every time we run this program. Don't you think that this code is much better? Let's do one thing. I want you to comment yes if you think this code is less complex and more efficient than the one we saw earlier. Now let's execute this program and check if it works. Let's first enter 28. For 28, the else clause should execute and the string "sorry, you have failed" should be displayed. Great, here is the desired result. Let's execute this program once again. This time, let's enter 78. For 78, the second elif statement should execute and the string "you have got first division with distinction" should be displayed back. Voila! Success again! Seems like we have a working code. If you want to know what happens in the background when we run this code, then go ahead and check out the blog. From that blog, you can also copy this code and use it for practice purposes. I will leave the link in the description. That's the tutorial on how to properly work with elif Python clause. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, then hit that thumbs up button and like the video. Most importantly, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for more interesting programming tutorials. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.